Hello everybody, this is Tiziano of Xworks, and today I'm going to release my Python library for Arduplane. In my previous videos, I've always talked about multi-copter, and one might wonder, are planes compatible with companion PCs? Of course, the answer is yes. Here at Xworks, where I work, we've been collaborating with the University of Tulsa, and we're providing support for their experimental setup. One of my recent tasks was creating a Python library for connecting with Arduplane and making things more explicit for developers to set up their code and grab variables from the plane and write their autonomous scripts. Today, I'm going to share this library on my GitHub account with you. As you will see, there's nothing extraordinary. It's just a wraparound dronekit toolkit where I simplified variables name and functions. For example, in order to get the position latitude rather than write vehicle.location.globalRelativeFrame.lat, you simply write plane.pauseLat. Easy. Furthermore, I added a couple of very useful functions, for example, arm and takeoff. You know that for plane, you cannot arm and takeoff like you do for the copter. You need to add a takeoff item in the mission and then set the vehicle to auto mode. In this video, I will quickly go through my library and we will just have a quick look to the main functions and variables. Then we're gonna write a simple script for testing our library. And later, we're gonna simulate everything in our software in the loop. And for the first time, we're gonna have a 3D visualization using the open source flight simulator Flightgear. And now, if you're excited, follow me in the next tutorial. Let's start up by initializing our vehicle, passing either the connection string or the vehicle object. The vehicle object can have been defined in your script before. And so if you're already connected with the vehicle, you just pass it during the initialization method. Otherwise, you just pass the connection string. That could be your UART and baud rate or the TCP or UDP address and port. Second thing I do, I set up listeners. Now the listeners, we already talked about that they are a very good way of listen to a telemetry message when it's coming from the vehicle so that we can deal with it. So rather than having something that always run in the background, it's something that it awakes only when it receives a certain message. Then here I have my internal variables like airspeed, ground speed, the position, latitude and longitude, the relative altitude above takeoff point, and the absolute altitude relative to mean sea level. Then I have the attitude, roll, pitch and yaw in degrees. And I have the wind information like the speed and also the direction, both going to and coming from. So depending on what you're gonna be using, I have both of them. Then I have the climb rate in meters per second and the throttle. Then I have the autopilot mode. Then here I store in mission, I store the mission items in the vehicle. And then two extra fields that are the location home and location current that are both in global relative type. Now let's go ahead and see some detail of those methods. For example, connect, I mean, this is pretty easy. It just connects using the connect function. And the setup listeners, what I define is, for example, a listener for the attitude, where, as you see, I just store roll, pitch, and yaw in degrees into my attitude roll, attitude pitch, and attitude yaw heading in degrees. And information from the wind, where I have wind speed, and then I have the direction, that is the direction coming from, that comes from the vehicle, and I transform this direction coming from into a go-to direction. Here it is, adding just 180 degrees and then having a module 360 degrees. Okay, so the main function I want to introduce you, arm and takeoff. Now, arm and takeoff is very useful, I feel, because arm and takeoff command works great for a copter, and what it does is just arms the vehicle, takes off, and puts the vehicle at a predefined altitude, and it waits there in guided mode. I wanted to do the same thing for a plane, so I created this arm and takeoff for a plane, and you would wonder, why can I just call the vehicle arm and takeoff function? Well, because it doesn't work for plane. Plane automatically takes off if you have a takeoff item in their mission and you set the vehicle into auto mode, and this is exactly what I do. The second function I want to introduce is a very simple function called set ground course. lets you set the ground, the direction, the flight direction in terms of ground course, not heading, because heading, the vehicle has to compensate for wind when it flies, and so setting the heading doesn't do any good. For what I'm gonna do, I just create a target that is located far away from me at the course that is provided by this angle deck. So it's like creating, it's like trying to chase this target and I would never reach. But in this way, the vehicle actually performs my autonomous script, just creating or setting the ground course of my vehicle. How does it do it? Well, it first calls this goto function. It's nothing more than vehicle simple goto to a location that I create using this other method, ground course to location, where I pass the angle and the altitude. The altitude can be none. If it's none, actually it keeps the current altitude as default. So the ground course to location, what it does, it just calls another function that is get target from bearing. A target from bearing creates this location that is based, is located at 5,000 meters from the vehicle at an angle that is the angle deck translated into radians. I pass my location current as the original location. And this get target from bearing, it just calls get location meters, and this get location meters actually does the job. So I don't want to go into much detail. You are free to explore the code. It's pretty easy, and you'll see that it's very, very useful for you guys. We're gonna now create a script, and we're gonna explore this system working in front of us. Here's what I want to do. I want to create a script for testing my library, and I'm going to create this script right here. We start off by checking whether name is equal main. In this case, we're going to create a parser for parsing our arguments. The main argument is connect, where the default is the TCP port 5762 on localhost. Then we're gonna create our object plane, passing the connection string. Now, in case the vehicle is not armed, we arm and take off, then we wait for 5 seconds. And then we start testing our ground course. We set our cruise altitude at 100 meters. We start our ground course at 0 degrees, and we set a delta angle of 20 degrees. Then in a while loop, we just call the method setGroundCourse, passing the current reference angle and the cruise altitude. Then we wait for 5 seconds, and then we increase the cruise angle by the delta angle, and we repeat. And let's print out the current reference course. Let's browse in the Autopilot repository, and then browse in Tools and Autotest, and select the batch file fgplaneview. This will launch Flightgear and make it listen to the proper UDP port. Then as usual, select the simulation pane emission planner, and start the simulation for a plane. Then browse on the folder libs, where there is the library plane.py, then keeping Shift pressed, right click, and select Open Command Window here. Now we just write Python, plane.py, and that's it. The system takes off and then starts giving ground course references by steps of 20 degrees. And I have some wind coming from east, so the system will drift toward west. So I hope that this library of mine would make things a little bit easier for whoever is dealing with Autopilot today. We recently had a lot of fun flying this library at the airfield with a foamy FPV plane, so I hope it's fully debugged. If you want to know more about setting up your companion PC and connecting with Arduplane or Arducopter, just check out my other videos. And also, if you want to download my free software, just check out my GitHub webpage. Don't forget to subscribe. And for now, I thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.